So right now only just now I just closed all my official work and started. So VM will take 1 or 2 minutes. Until that, do you have any question? Any doubts? Yesterday we have discussed about scope, the basics, right? We have seen completely with the hands on itself. So do you have any question that? So these are all the key points that we have discussed yesterday. How the architecture was working, that all we have discussed. You can remember, right, everything? Okay, takes few minutes. Before that, we just complete our the assignments. Okay. So this is the basic assignment only I just created. And keep on, I will include one by one assignments. Okay, so final one project, and before that we will be seeing 1 3 project at least. That's I planned with you, but these assignments you have to do it from your end. That's an important. Okay, this is a sample architecture I have designed. So whatever the data right now we have MySQL, I'm trying to update the VM with Oracle or SQL Server additionally. So what you are going to do it, you're going to create the scope jobs and going to interact with MySQL or any other one server. Okay, so both data you are going to migrate to Hadoop environment based on incremental importing. It's a scope import operation only you are going to do it. I will tell you what is incremental importing that you are going to see in the future classes. So based on that, you are going to inject the data into Hadoop environment as a Pocket file. Okay, so we will discuss about the file format, different file format, how we can achieve via scope, that we will discuss. So all the data you will be migrated to the Hadoop environment, and then you have to use that Hive external table on top of the layer, and you will be do some summarized output or whatever. That final output you have to store into the partition table with the bucketing options. Okay, are you able to do these things? Right now you just take MySQL table. MySQL table, we have retail DB. If you have any other data set, you just bring it and do some analysis with that also. Otherwise, you have a business case studies, you are facing some issues in your business case studies, just take it out and do some analysis. And you just do the same with your big data processing with your real time, because I just give you the VM. So that's your own VM only right now. So whatever the data you needed, you can inject it and you can try it out. So right now you'll not be working with big data environment or different environment. You just do practice with the same data structure with this big data platform. Then this will help you to clear that interview. That's what I'm saying. With reality, we just making some practical in Hadoop definitely will help you while explaining about the architecture.
Okay, Dinesh.
You got my point, right?
The final, what is the dashboard, Dinesh?
That's a dashboard, is a tabular. Whatever you have knowledge, you can do that. That's Hive integration is available. I will check it out. Most probably, I will go over to Grafana or what is it? Zeppelin is available. Zeppelin also is not a free. It's a Spark integration. We will do with the Spark also one more project. We will try it out these things. Okay. So what are all you are going to study that we will be going to apply it with that architecture. All of you is okay for you?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. So
Yes.
data set I will give you your own. You just select your data set as you desired. Or in our VM, we have retail DB data set. Just take two table. You just migrate those table into Hadoop environment as a Pocket file. And then you can do some joins between that. Sorry, you just create two Hive table on that and create some join. That final output you're going to insert into the partitioning and bucketing table. Okay. That's your which data set. I just give you your option, whatever you just select, and do this analysis. When this can be complete by you.
This
That's
is
fine.
one time load, right? So here we don't repeat incremental
No,
load, right?
right now you are going to practice with your single one-time import, but I just mentioning, right? These are incremental options that we are going to study in the scope. So you also going to learn about this thing, and you're going to apply with your practical. Okay, so you just try first with this normal scope import, and then you just go with practical in an incremental import after our session is completed.
Okay,
when I can get this? When you can submit this?
Monday, Dinesh. Monday.
Others? Today is Wednesday, right?
Yeah.
Monday, everyone can finish, right? So
I will try to. Actually, in my office, one deployment is going on.
Okay.
So, but I'll try my best to complete it by Monday. But okay. I'm not able to, then after that deployment is done, but I'll complete it.
Okay. So everyone is fine with Monday, right? Sunil, what about
yes.
you?
Yes, Dinesh.
You can, right? So I just want to know this detail, project overview, what you are doing, what kind of data set you have taken, and what you are going to approach with this architecture, what is the data output you will be getting it. All the information I need to get as a summarized. And then your commands or queries or whatever you will be used, right? All the detail. I just want to verify if anything missed or right. And every day I will go, we are going to test with everyone. You have to share your screen and explain what you have done. Okay. If it is a business data set, then one-to-one I will take it out. If it is a common data set you are taken, then we will go with group. Because people will know something, right? You also face some issues, you will be stuck somewhere. You just try Google, then only you can get some outputs.
The data set is given by you, or we can take our own data.
Already retail DB is available in VM itself.
Okay.
Okay, in our VM, you just check in MySQL DB, retail DB data is available. So here retail DB is available, right? So these many columns available. Mostly I'm taking the session with you, orders and customers only. So you just take other tables. Okay, mostly customer table have your data. It will map with another two tables, anything, department is available or order item, something. If you're taking orders, order ID will be a mapping table. If you're taking customer, customer will be go with department or product, something will be available. So just check and probably you just find out the mapping table. Okay, for the our practice, I am going with this two table only, customers and order. But you can take any one with respect to, you can select another one table. Okay. This is for your practice, I'm saying.
Okay.
So today is Wednesday. Everyone promised on Monday. I will give you the day, one day. So Tuesday, I will check one by one. Or we can sit with some discussion session on the day. Okay. So during this time, you learn about the basics of scope, and you have some knowledge in scope as well. Everything you can complete. Mostly Tuesday we will be connect back with the discussion session. At the time itself, we will go with your assignments. Is it okay, all of you?
Yes, Dinesh.
Yes, Dinesh.
Okay. So today I will share you all the details. This information and slide, everything I will share you. Just do practice from your end. Okay, now we can start our session. So just recap, what is scope? Scope is nothing but SQL plus Hadoop is a short name, is called scope. So it should be interact only with the RDBMS, because it's SQL based Hadoop operation it will be doing, it's a migration operation. So one part should be in RDBMS, another part should be in Hadoop environment. This is the way you can achieve via scope. So in likewise, you can do in reverse manner. You can export the data from Hadoop to RDBMS. That is also possible in via scope. That is called export operations. So import and export. And these are all the tables is available that we yesterday we have seen how we can connect it, how we can get the data. And we have tried everything, the basics with MySQL. Yesterday, the small import operation we have tried. And three key points majorly we have to remember. That first one is thing, the data should be as compatible with Java compatible, and it should be in Scoop library, will be in Java connected, should be available. Any RDBMS you are going to connect based on the compatible Java, it's a jar file, you have to load it. Yesterday session I was showing to you how the jar was stored, where it was stored, everything we have seen for the MySQL table. And then we have discussed about architecture, what we are doing in this architecture, how it is reflecting our data, when it is going to use the mapper, when it is not using the mapper, and why Redis is not working, that function we have discussed yesterday, I guess. And SQL, that scoop tool argument, so tool name, what are the tool name will come, and with respect to tool argument, whatever will come, yesterday we have discussed. So based on that, we have seen generic argument also. So particular tool argument, if you select, based on that, what are the generic argument you have to provide? It's a sub options, additional options like that. Based on that, your selection, if you're going to select for import option, based on that, you need to provide other parameters. If you're going to select for export, based on that, that drill down option will be modified. So that's we have discussed yesterday. And then we just connect and retrieve the data via scope operation yesterday. Hope you remember right. So this time the mapper will not be running. We have discussed the causes of the reason also. And evaluate how we can shoot the query via scope to RDBMS and get the data. That we have seen. What is the difference between the passwordless operation based on the console password in operation yesterday we have discussed. And scope import, how we can do that operation, that scope import. So yesterday we have seen only one example till now, because all other answers we have completed, that evaluation and that freeform, sorry, what is that, listed tables, that yesterday we have seen. And the scope import, how we can inject the data to our Hadoop environment with a single mapper, that we have discussed. Right, till now any questions?
What is metadata?
Metadata is nothing but scoop details will be stored. I told you, right, that incremental operation. That I will take later. At the time, this is based on the metadata only will be going to inject it. It will be stored what kind of, sorry, how many data was injected, what is the last value I have inserted. So if suppose I'm going to execute again, then it's going to be, it's not going to get that old data. Whatever come after that, that record only will be getting it. So this information will be stored in metadata deposit. Let's for example, I have 1,000 records today. Sorry, yesterday I just stored. So today I'm getting again 1,000 records. So this operation is going to be start from 1001 to 2000. Instead of 1 to 1000, it should be start from 1001 to 2000 records. Correct? So this information will be stored in that metadata repository. That I will tell you in this job and this incremental operation. Later point it will come, we will discuss that things. It helps to avoid your duplication and continuous injection operations. Okay?
Yeah, okay, Dinesh.
Any other question?
From my side, no.
Others?
No.
Thank you. Okay, so we can see with rest of the hands are one by one. So yesterday we have seen a small example, right? So single mapper, how it was done. So this is all the command. I forgot to give you this command, I guess. I'm sorry. Today I will share these things. Okay. So single mapper, how it is running, evaluation command, list tables, list DB, everything we have discussed yesterday. So now we just going to with multiple mapper. So number of mapper equal to number of files. Am I right? Open LS. Yesterday we have tried with the single mapper. So only one file was created. What is the meaning for pot hyphen m and that file, that numbers that we have discussed yesterday? I think so. So this is the data will be injected. Okay, example data yesterday we have seen. Okay, today the same query I am going to execute with multiple mappers. I just take it out with two mapper right now. Okay, multiple mapper, I just mentioned like that. Here I just mentioning into number of mapper equal to 2. Okay, this is not a single mapper. So everything same, right? Scope import connect table database name yesterday we have created. Table name import export username password, where the file has to store that information, how many mapper we have to inject it. Okay, now I'm going to execute it. Yeah.
In scope also, do we have anything like a zookeeper that runs behind the screen, something like that? Because here I see
Hadoop only will be followed, right? So it's going to be identified via Hadoop only, that's it. The zookeeper will be is a wrapper of Hadoop environment. So map produce will be function via scope, that's it. Zookeeper mainly monitor with your Hadoop environment. So whether you are trying to inject the data via Scoop, at the time Zookeeper can be monitored and informed to our Hadoop environment somebody is going to inject the data. That information only you're getting it. Okay. And are you clear there? Pushpendra, are you clear?
Yeah, Dinesh.
Okay. Pushpendra or Sabarish? Who asked the question?
Sabarish.
Okay, I'm sorry. Okay, so now I tried, but it's throwing some error. The reason behind, no primary key could be found. Okay, if you are trying to execute with multiple mapper, then you should need a primary key. If table doesn't have a primary key, then you need to include where it is. I may have missed split by. I think the slide was modified. Okay. Okay. So that is called a split by. If you have this command, then only you can inject it. Okay. Because if it is a single file, enter the table will be converted and store it, right? if it is multiple mapper, then it should need to understand, right, how I can going to split the record. That's important one thing, right? Let's say, for example, use demo underscore one, show tables, select start from EMP. So here I have four record, I'm going to inject it. If it is a single file, then all the record will be stored. If it is a multiple file, we need to split it, correct? Whether it should be going to split by two via that name based or ID based. Anything I need to inform them, right? That is called a split by operation. If you have a primary key by default with ID, then it will not ask you. Based on the ID, it's going to be split the record. But if you don't have a primary key in your table, then you need to mention the split by operations. --by, I just going to split by ID. Okay, now I'm going to execute it. You're getting my point? So I just mentioning it's a two mapper, right? So it's going to be divided by two, and it will be injected two records per one file, another two records per another file.
Nice. My system got disconnected. Can you come again regarding that split thing?
So split by, that is we are discussing still now. Okay. If it is a single mapper, then split by is not required. Okay, entire the table you just migrated, then nothing is required, directly you can achieve it. But if you are trying go with more than one mapper, then two scenarios available. One is should be primary key in your table. Or use split by command and mention your divide columns. Okay, so the two way you can achieve. If already own primary key with your RDBMS table, then it's not required. But if you need to split without primary key table, then you need to use this split by command. Are you clear now, Sabrish?
Yes, Dinesh.
Okay, now the record, sample record, four record only we have injected. We're just going to see. DFS, DFS, -LS. Okay, so two file was generated. Partition of mapper of zero index file, partition of mapper of zero first index file. SDFS, DFS, -cat, and I'm going to retrieve the data. Okay. So it's going to be split total record divided by two, and first two record for the first file, second two record for second file. Like this, it's splitted. Are you clear?
No, without using split, we can give you your mapper two, right? So default, it will split into two partition, right?
No, if you have a primary key in your table, where it is table, this is a table name, right? If you have a own primary key in this table, then default mapper 4 will be running and fetching the data.
Okay.
Let's say, for example, I'm going to run with the default mapper now.
What I'm asking is, if you don't give the split by ID, so default it will take as a two partition, right? Mapper 1 and mapper 2, like partitions.
Four mapper will be taken. I just check with the default mapper now. I didn't declare any number of mapper. I just removed all the information. Okay, so it cannot be identified how we can split it. It requests for the split byte command. Simply, I just include this split byte. I didn't declare any mapper right now. Okay, I just executed with the default mapper and it's going to be executed with the ID.
So Dinesh, will it try to divide it equally into all the files?
Yes. So total number of record will be split by 4. And you can see this is the boundary query they are saying. It's just going to select min and max of this table. Based on that, it's going to be analyzed. So maximum 4 is available. Number of mapper is 4. And it's going to be divided by 4. And each file will be created with only one record.
Okay. So if it is, if you are trying to create more than one mapper file or say one file, then we'll have to give it give the split by command.
Yeah, if primary key is available, not required.
Okay.
If not there, then you have to mention split by.
Okay.
Okay, 4 record injected. This is for the die dataset yesterday we have created. So for reference only, I'm doing DFS-LS. So default 4 mapper is running the begin. 4 file created. --cat and retrieve the data. Okay, so Sabarish is the first record. Second file won't split. Pushpendra, likewise, all the file will be created. Are you clear?
Yes, yes.
Okay, so now we just going to see with different file format. So same command, okay, so I don't want to create multiple file. I just simply declare as mapper1, num-mapper also you can declare like that, or -m and then you can provide that value of mapper. This is also possible. Likewise, you can declare. So now I'm going to convert this data and store into single mapper, and this will be a pocket file, right? m1_forket, like that I just declare. For the easy reference, I just mentioned. Okay, and one more thing. It should be run with as -forket file, like you think.
Dinesh, if we don't give this target directory, so okay. will it go to the default directory, something like that, Dinesh, or we have to go?
No, it should be request for the directory where I have to store it. It's not a hive, right? So you have to declare definitely with the target directory.
Okay.
Okay. And one more thing. Okay, later I will tell you one more. So scope import, the same table I'm going to convert and store into this directory with the hyphen hyphen pocket file. And during that, we have discussed about this pocket file as well. So file format, it will be support Avro sequence text pocket file will be supported by Scoop. Okay, ORC file is not supported directly due to metadata incorrect references. It will not be accept that file. Otherwise, pocket Avro sequence text file will be supported via Scoop and you can inject it. Most preferably, they will go with pocket file because pocket file very close to your Java integrations. So Java development, they will be using pocket file in the backend as well. Pocket file is nothing but it's a column based file format. So all the records will be going to store based on that columnar format. I will show you the output, then we will discuss more about it. Okay, total 4 record will be identified and phased out. LDFS, DFS, hyphen, LS. So now you can see metadata, signals as well. One file was generated. It's not a part hyphen M. Because it's uniquely created an extension with N with pocket.
For every query you given the same path here, so it will be like overwriting for each.
No. The next example we can try again with the same directory. Okay, this is the record is available. You are not very clear about the record, but this is the pocket file format. While we are using with Spark, right? At the time, I will showing you how we are going to interact with the different file format. That is the one of thing is pocket. Another one is Avro or ORC. We will see some examples. Okay, is it fine? Any question till now?
Dinesh, if we are trying to save it as an Avro file, then for the schema, how do we do it? Like schema, should we provide it?
No, your data from the table is retrieved, right? So it just applying the schema and create it. That's it.
Okay.
Okay. So we'll go into see with Avro data file. With the same directory, we'll see now what is happening. I'm going to create a new one. Okay, for the same directory, I'm going to insert now. Now you're clear, right? This project flow. So that pocket file, how we can store via Scoop. That's we have seen just before. For incremental load, I will take after 1 or 2 days. Okay, now you can see pocket, this directory already exists. So you cannot inject the data into this directory right now. Correct? What I'm going to do, I'm just going to convert into Avro. And again, I'm going to submit it.
Dinesh, this m1_avro is a folder that you are creating through the Scoop command, right?
Exactly.
Okay.
Okay, so for record right now it was created and stored. LDFS-LS. Any question, guys? Still no any doubts or any question? This is comes with the Avro extension, and you can see the file formats. Guys, are you clear till now?
Yes, Dinesh.
I will share all the commands to you. Just do practice from your end. Okay. So till now we have seen the file format and just import the table. I think no questions. And now we are going to how we are going to import entire the database. Not for a single file, the entire the database we are going to migrate. Okay. So let's say for example, this is the database, right? Which one? Demo_1. There is only one table is available. I'm going to create another one table. Create table. _1. Okay. So insert into employee 1 values 5. Yesterday host name is missed.
Okay.
My name is.
Okay. Sonel. Okay. So one more again, I am going with Sonel. And another one record. Big data PDF. Okay, so select star from emp_1. So 3 record is available in employee 1 and 4 record is available in employee 2. Now I am going to export entire the database into our Hadoop via Scoop. That is nothing but command is simple but small changes. Mainly interview also they are asking this one. Import database. Because most of the time we cannot execute one by one, right? So at the time we can go with enter the database imports. For the reference, I just declare like that. Scoop import -all tables. This is the command we have to use it. Connectivity is same and there is to table details not required. And username as a root and password and directory is not required. Sorry, target directory. Instead of target directory, it will come with warehouse directory. Okay. So warehouse directory mostly will be used only for database imports. If it is a table imports, then you have to use as a target directory. Interview, they will ask what is the difference between target directory and warehouse directory. This is the actual difference. And then I just declare where I am going to store. So import all tables, that is the directory I just informed them to create with single mapper. _m1, like that I just declare.
Dinesh, can you come again about the difference between warehouse directory and target?
Warehouse means you have to store entire the right entire the data. So whenever you are going to execute import all table, like a database injections, then you have to declare as a warehouse directory. If you are trying with only a table based, then you have to declare as a target directory. Are you clear?
Yes, Dinesh.
So mostly they will ask what is the difference between a warehouse directory and target directory. Michelle, are you clear?
Yes, Dinesh.
Now I'm going to execute import all tables underscore one. It's a directory I'm going to insert. Now one job was created and trying to inject it right now. So it is going to be select for employee table. Now it is injecting employee table now. Mapper reduce started.
Dinesh, now no primary key or split key is not needed for the entire table database.
That's what I just declare as a single mapper.
Yeah, got it.
So retrieved four record for employee one, so employee table. Again, new job was started with the employee underscore one table now.
Yeah, got it. If we give multiple mappers, then we need to.
Based on that, you have to declare that column details. Which column you have to. Otherwise, you have all the table should be a primary key. It's little conflict to us. So mostly the development, they are doing like this only. iPhone M1.
Okay.
That's safe for us.
Like if we have large data, then we need to include multiple mappers, right?
If it is some large data, then it will be going to execute based on that. It's a continuous basis, right? So yes, if it is a large table, then they will not go with the database pick. Because mostly the transaction they will be doing it, right? Let's say, for example, I have a finance database is available. Only one table have all the data, correct? That's a transaction table.
Yes.
Other tables are just a meta store table, correct?
Yes.
So what they are doing, they will not be migrate into the table itself. They just, it's a database. They just ignore that particular table, that what are all the tables available, big data. That table they will be avoided. Rest of the table they are going to migrate via this command. Import all tables.
Okay.
So that only one table they are going to execute via continuous injection basis. In case of failure, is anything happen, then it will be bottlenecked to you, right? So they will go with multiple continuous injection basis. Okay, I will tell you how we can avoid it. Till now, enter the data we have moved from the database. But such kind of scenario, we need to avoid that particular table, right?
Yes.
The next example, we will see that things. Okay, so this is the directory. That's DFS, DFS, hyphen LS. Import all table underscore M1. There you can see EMP is one kind of directory. EMP underscore one is another one directory. SDFS, DFS, hyphen LS. So it will be stored with your entire data. SDFS, DFS, hyphen L, cat, your data. So four records is available. Now the same pod file only will be created. But for its employee underscore one table. So rest of the three record is available now.
Created.
Okay. So likewise, the entire table you can migrate. Each one table create as a own directory. There the file will be stored. You will not do it anything. By backend, it will be doing all the operations.
Okay.
So if I apply like multiple mappers here, then should we specify it for every table? Like, so for example, the first table, you will be mentioning it as ID, and for the second table, something else. Then how do we mention the?
That's the reason directly we cannot do that. It should be a generic ID. If suppose all the table you have an ID column, it's a common, then you can mention it split by ID is fine. But if it is a different for all the table, you cannot inject the data. That's the reason we are using -m1.
Okay.
Okay. So let's say, for example, I have a table, right? Okay. I have a table, employee, department, what is that? Payroll, attendance, anything else? Attendance, any other table? The attendance only will have more data. So employee, you have 10,000 records available. Department only 100 maximum department will be available. Payroll system will be equal to your employee table only. So 10,000 records into 12. How many? 12, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So 120,000 records is available. But attendance, whenever you are going to swipe in or swipe out, or you are going to the office or come out, all the information will be stored. So here it will be stored with 1.2 billion records available. Let's say, for example. Okay. So these many records available, I need to avoid this and enter the table. I can migrate as a single import database commands, right? Because this is a very less record, there is no impact will happen while I'm going to migrate into Hadoop environment. This is the only one is the actual transaction record. It only have own or this much of records needed, correct? So we have to avoid this, and rest of the table we have to include. And this is, we can go with continuous. Continuous ingestions. Rest of that we can go with database imports. Am I right? This is easy, right? Otherwise each table we have to migrate. Are you clear, guys? Any doubts?
If we need to import all the tables, exclude some two or three tables. So how can I write it?
That's what I'm saying. Now, till now, all the tables available in that one database, that's we have tried. But now I'm going to exclude this table. Rest of the table, I'm going to import it via this DB import command. Okay. That is for the scenario I'm telling. This is the way you have to do it in your business problem. Any question?
For attendance one, will be like incremental import from MySQL.
We have to do it incremental import only.
Yeah, got it.
Wherever you have a data more, there you have to go with incremental import.
Yeah, got it.
So this situation, I'm going to exclude this table. Rest of that I can import at the same time. So the command is same.
Dinesh, one question. So that incremental load or import, basically it will come when there is a frequent addition of data to it, right?
Yeah, continuously the data will be,
okay.
Day by day you will be increasing the value.
Increasing,
right?
The value. Okay.
So that's you have to migrate.
Okay.
That's called, that's a transaction table, or they will be mentioning as a fact table. If you're using schema based, then they will be saying as a fact table. Okay. So other tables will be a dimension table, and this will be a fact table. So fact table only mostly you'll be using for incremental operation. Dimension table is like a master table. You will not be doing any changes more. Okay.
Dinesh, one more question. So in the previous command, right, when you are importing all the entire database, so in that, if I give say two mappers, then say both the tables will be having ID as a primary key, for example. Then in that case, the mapper will be assigned for each of the table individually, right? So in the first EMP tape, EMP folder, you will be having two files. And in the EMP1 folder also, you'll be having two files, correct?
Default mapper, however, you'll be selecting...
No, I'm just using two mappers.
Then it will be creating two mapper only.
Okay, for each of the table, it will be using
the exactly, exactly. Okay. That's the use of number of mapper. But that should be the column should be in same.
Okay.
Okay.
Dinesh, one question. Let's say I have five tables.
Okay.
And in all the five tables have different primary key. So we can't explicitly say that for this table, this is the primary key.
That's not required. While it's going to be read the data at the time, it can be understand about the primary key. So you don't want to declare anything. If you have all the table with the primary key, then you can declare number of mapper, no issues.
But if at all, let's say my data is a bit huge and I want to import all the data, but I can see that only one mapper can't suffice my requirement. So I need to have more than one mapper. So how to tackle that situation?
That's what I'm saying. If you have more than one mapper, then you just include a primary key in your table. If you declare the number of primary key in your table, that's it. Directly you can import it with multiple mappers.
So for each table, I have to define that this is my primary key, right?
Yeah, that's an important.
Okay.
Then you can simply identify it and complete it. Okay. So let's say, for example, this table, everything having ID. It should be a department ID, payroll ID, employee ID, but you declared as a ID only.
Mm-hmm.
Then everything is the same. Based on that, you can split into number of mapper. Then fine, it will be work for, because all the table have same column. This is the one way you can achieve it. Otherwise, if you have all the table with the primary key, then also number of mapper you can go with it. No issues. Clear?
Yes.
Dinesh, say for in a database we have five tables. In the five are different tables. In two tables we have primary keys, and the three tables we don't have any primary keys. So in the case we need to give any split command, Dinesh.
That's I'm saying we can do via two options. We can avoid whatever table is not available the primary key. We can avoid the table. Rest of that we can migrate it. This is the way you can do it. Otherwise, what you have to do, you have to include the primary key for other three tables. By randomly, you can include it. Okay, once data migrated, while you're selecting the table, right, at the time, you don't want to select the primary key values, primary key column there. Likewise, you can migrate it, but you need to alter the table. If suppose all the table have a column, exact same column is available, there is no impact to you. Split by that you mentioning the column name is enough. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, first we will see the hands on and I will come to your question. Okay, so number of mapper I just mentioned. I'm going to create one more table here. Okay, employee 2, ID is 7, Dinesh, start from EMP underscore 2. Oh, so sorry, it was inserted into employee 1 itself. Okay, only one record is available. So fortunately, I don't want this table. This is a huge record is available something. I'm going to exclude this employee to table. Rest of that I'm going to insert it. So that you have to use this one. Table name is underscore exclude is a directory. Number of mappers of one. And then you just want to declare hyphen hyphen exclude hyphen tables. And then which table you want to exclude, you just share that information. That's it. So now I'm going to shoot the query again. It's going to be read your entire table from the database and it's going to be executed one by one. And here you can see first table employee has started now. It's going to be inject now the data into this directory, that a underscore exclude directory, right? There it's going to be inject the record. And then employee one is going to be take it out and inject the record as well. Okay, so four record from employee table is inserted. Employee underscore one is going to be inserted. That four record right now, three or four. Recently one inserted. Four record is available. So employee one table is started now.
Dinesh, say for example, if we have 5 GB of data size,
okay,
then how much time it will take while running this scoop command, Dinesh?
This is you're saying 5 GB, then yeah. It's a file, so we cannot reassure.
No.
Right? This is the file you mentioned.
Not file, I'm saying like tables, we have like the size of like 5 GB data.
Table sizes, you cannot directly declare how many size because it's a compressed and data file is different. Everything will be stored based on the MDF, LDF file format only in backup. You cannot assure that is the correct file format.
So what I'm asking is if you
have a large data, that data will come to close to 1 GB. How, that is your question, I guess, right?
So what I'm asking is for these four records, it was taking some around 2 to 3 minutes to run this SQL, this scope command, right?
Yeah.
So if you have like more than 50,000 records, say for example, so in that case, how much time it will take for running the scope command?
Yeah, that depends on your data sizes will be modified. You said 50,000 record, right?
Yeah.
50,000 record available for a single column as well, or 100 column also. So based on your data column and rows, that data size will be modified. So we cannot assure how long it will take it out. So we have to go with the trial and error. Because if it is a single column, then 50,000 record, 1,500 record, then okay. So single column only within a time period, short time, it just injected. But just 15,000 record, but it's like a horizontal scaling data. You have close to 100 columns available. Then the size is huge.
Yeah.
So it will be modified. So based on that, we cannot assure how many will be running back. Okay.
Okay.
We can go with the trial and error basis. First time, how long it will take it out. So based on that, we can select for further process.
Kota.
Oh, sorry. SDFS. Any question? Sorry. Guys, did you ask anything?
Nothing, Dinesh.
Savita was asking some question.
Okay. So SDF of DFS, siphon, cat and file. So same like, but excluded employee underscore table 2. Employee underscore 2 table is just ignore it. Okay, this is the way you can explore the table. But that one table also important, right? That is the major data is available. That is, we can go with continuous injection basis via scoop also. Okay, that's we will see by tomorrow or day after tomorrow. Till now, you are clear, right? This commands.
So Dinesh, the question that I have is, so if the table, if out of the four tables, one table has a huge data, then that should also be loaded using continuous injection, right?
Yeah, that is, you have to go with continuous injection.
Okay, other irrespective of whether the table will be updated frequently or not, we'll be going with continuous injection, correct?
Yeah, correct.
Okay.
That depends on the data size. Let's say, for example, you have 100 billions of records. Not for million, billions of record. 100 okay. billions of record, while you are trying to migrate to Hadoop environment, you will be facing failures again. Right? So yeah. We can slicing the data. So you will be going to insert it based on the number of mappers.
So you're applying the mappers only for that particular table.
Yeah, that particular table you can declare with 100 mapper or 200 mapper, 500 mapper. Depends on your cluster size, you can divide it. So what will be happen, your data will be split based on the partitioning sizes. It's going to inject into your environment. You have properly 100 billion of record you have included.
Okay.
Now, again, 1 billion record, daily value it just included. Again, you have to start 1 billion of record only instead of 100 billion, right? So that's the important thing. That is, we can achieve via this continuous operations. Day volume or continuous based batch processing we can execute, so data automatically will be pulled into your environment. If you are trying the same with your Java or other programming, then it's bottleneck to you, right? You have to analyze everything. Once you analyze, then only you can start your job and you have to write the code. It takes long time. At least for the table migration, minimum 1 week you need to complete your code development and all, and then only you can migrate the data. But via scoop, it's simply you can migrate the data. It won't take more than 10 minutes or 15 minutes for code development. But data injection will take for 1 hour or 2 hours. So maximum within a 1 day, you can migrate the data. Am I right?
Yeah.
That is a possible.
Okay.
That's the reason most of the people will go with that distribution environment as well as cloud-based distribution. So they are going to buy that cloud environment for 1 day or 2 day. They will be migrate the data and just simply they will be close it. And they can pay for only 1 or 2 days amount only. That's very easy, right? Otherwise we have to buy that entire hardware on premises and then only we can start our operation. That's very irritating to us. Low simplicity and cost effective manner. Okay.
Okay.
Any question? Till now, are you clear, guys?
Yes, Dinesh.
Yes, Dinesh.
Yes, Dinesh.
Okay. So I will share you this code and everything to you. As well as slide, as well as assignments. We will just do trial and error by tomorrow itself for school and then start your assignment. There you will get some clarity and try it out. Okay, you may face any issues. You just inform to our group. Other people also will be faced the same issue. They will help you. If they cannot help you at the time, I will help you in that part. Okay, you have to coordinate together and do this analysis. That's the reason I just created a separate batch for you.
Okay.
Okay, the people will help you. They also practically they will be facing some issues, they will come to you. You just mingle together and try out your queries. If nothing is possible, then I will help you. Okay?
Yeah, okay, Dinesh.
Any other question?
No, Dinesh.
Because let's say after this session completed, somebody go for an interview. Somebody will not be get ready for the interview. So you just share the question, what are the questions they are asked, what are the questions will not be answered, everything you just share the group. Other people will help you. At the same time, everyone will learn what kind of question they will be asked. Correct? So it will be collaborated. Then the same question other people will be get in that interview, another one interview, they will be get placed very soon. That's what I'm saying. Do practice. Don't copy paste like me. Try to enter everything based on the keys. Then only you can memorize it. While in interview, they will ask you to write the code. I have a daily 1 hour, so I cannot do it entirely. I can. The first query only, I will be write it. Rest of the query, I just go with copy and paste. But you don't do like that. You just, whatever the query, you just key it by your own. Then only you can remember. While in interview also, you can immediately write the code to them to get confidence. My humble request, try with, don't copy paste, try with your keying method. Okay?
Okay.
Any question?
No.
Okay, if no, okay, we can wind up today. Others?
No question, Dinesh.
No question, Dinesh.
Okay. Okay, guys. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dinesh. Good night.
Good night.
Dinesh. Good night.
Thank you, Dinesh.